Carol wrote in to us from Newton, Mass.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure I'm being overlooked for jobs because I'm perceived as overqualified.
Okay.
I am a young 65-year-old strategic marketing manager who has only been out of work for 3 years while I cared for my aging parents. I'm afraid that companies don't want to hire an older worker like me. I'm expensive. How can I convince employers that I am worth the investment?
First, I want to start by complimenting Carol on the way she phrased the question, because you recognize that it is a big investment to bring an employee on, and I'm not sure everybody recognizes that. So depending on whose data you believe, and depending on how complex the industry is, an employer does not make money, or even break even, on a new hire until somewhere between 18 and 36 months. So an employer can hire someone and not make money on them for 3 years. Mm. So it is absolutely beholden on you as the candidate, you meaning all of you, to be able to explain to an employer why you are worth the investment. So it was a great question. So it's complicated because right now we're talking about age, but sometimes age can work against you on the other end. There is certainly bias against the 20-somethings who have a reputation, I think probably ill-earned, of being slackers or not being rule followers. Mm-hmm. And then of course there are the issues on the other end with older employees, maybe not being tech savvy, maybe not having the energy level, etc. So you need to do your best to debunk any of these types of myths that are out there, and they exist. One thing that's working in your favor, though, is that the age at which people leave work now is getting later and later. I know I mentioned my mom in a prior episode. She's 79, and she started her second career at 50, and she's still going strong. So with her as a role model and seeing other older colleagues of mine continuing to thrive and work their way through a changing work environment, I think it's good timing, but still tricky.
Yeah, and I also think that we are waiting to change that mindset. And it's women like you. It's women out there having these conversations, showing up for these interviews, and really, you know, forging the path for others behind you that needs to happen. But in the meantime, while we're waiting for that mindset shift to happen.
There are a couple things you can do. So let's start with the first, and I think probably the easiest for you, is to take a look at your situation and look at the two biggest objections that people have with older employees. And really, they're both centered on cost. One is you're too expensive because you've been earning here and this job offers here. Now, there's the chance that you might take less money, but there's always that distrust that you're just taking this job until you can get back in a job that's going to pay you where you were. And then the second being just the expense of insurance. I mean, you know, older employees tend to tax the insurance plans of the benefit plans of companies more than younger employees. It's just a fact. So one easy way to navigate around that, again, if this works for your situation, is to represent yourself as a contractor. So I've had great success with clients helping them present themselves as someone who can take on a special project, help out during crunch time, just kind of ease your way in. You do, in some cases, have something to prove, particularly if the manager you're working for is 31. Okay, you're probably older than their parents. So like it or not, it's something that you have to deal with. And there are objections across the spectrum that need to be addressed. We're focusing on yours. So if you have the ability to get on a spouse's benefits, if maybe you have benefits in place from an old work contract or a defined benefit plan, if you have a retirement, anything that might allow you to represent yourself as a contractor is a great way to get in. In my prior experience in placing people, we found that 60% of people who went into a company in a contract capacity ended up staying either for future projects or as a regular employee. So I think that could work well for you.
Yes, and and there's so much value that you add that we need. We absolutely need that. So don't get downtrodden about this. It can be it can be an exhausting process. And that is why I beg you to go and find our self-care episode and really take care of yourself during this time. We can often get down on ourselves and we stop our self-care. And listen, it is a marathon and you need to take care of yourself. You're important. We need what you have to offer. And so taking care of yourself so you are on top of your game is crucial
And really important. Yeah, and really believing that. So I would say the second thing that, people like Carol can do would be to really have what I like to call a come to Jesus meeting with yourself. I mean, to really be honest, because if your skills are not current, if you do not have social media savvy as a marketing person, mm-hmm. if you don't understand the marketing trends, mm-hmm. if you were working, let's say, 3 years ago in a very big company with a department of 150 people, yeah. where you kind of out of touch yes. with some of the tactical work that's being done, you're going to be at a disadvantage. Mm-hmm. So, and this is the hard part. We help you through the course yeah. with this, having these really honest conversations with yourself and being able to say, Carol or Susan, you know what? You can't hide behind this, I'm not being hired because I'm overqualified anymore. Yeah. There's something else in here. Yeah. So we help you tease out the myth yep. from the reality so you can really understand where you might have some control to improve your results. Yep. So we hope you'll join us for the course. Yes. We think that people like you have a lot to glean from it.
A lot to offer, and you are a part of a bigger, greater movement
Absolutely.
That is happening.
There is so much more that we'd like to impart with you, so much more we'd like to teach you.
Yes.
So please get on our mailing list. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you.